Hello everyone, I'm Greycloak, thank you for joining me, and welcome back to Factorio for Bob's Mods and Stuff, episode 133. So we are going to improve our oxygen production even more, so we can produce some more lead and solder. I guess lead was the main problem, right? That's waiting for solder, that's waiting for solder. Oh, so solder is the main problem, never mind. But our problem was lead, so lead for batteries. And as per usual, we can't get rid of this fast enough. That a bit better, maybe? Probably not. We can't keep up with all of these, so let's turn it down a bit. Still can't keep up. Might as well just get rid of all of them and just add more machines, I guess. Or we could just add more vents. How will that work out? Well, we don't have that many vents. Now, what happens if we speed this up then? Seems like it's quite alright. Can't keep all of these though, not with... if I want the power pole to be in the middle. Oh, that OCD. This seems to be okay though. So now the water can't keep up, of course. That's a bit better. That starts up this whole line at least. Then we can just make more lines, I guess. Or do the same for all of the other lines, at least. Oh, let's not use... oh dear. Too bad, we'll probably have to have two power poles on each of these. And we need pipe. Should we just make that ourselves? I guess we should. We do craft quite fast now. Oops. Well, we're almost out of underground pipe as well, so we will need a lot more of that, and why am I not just doing this over here? Up here, I guess. And why can this not reach when the other one could? Oh. Like that. That seems okay to me. So we are starting to produce quite a lot again. Some of these are still needing the lead oxide though, so let's increase the oxygen production even further, I guess. Well, these are full now. Is it just that I removed that? I guess it is. Then they should start emptying out again, I guess. Maybe not. Maybe that can't keep the whole thing running. Shouldn't really need all of it, but I think this is okay. We're still in a deficit of the lead oxide apparently, but that's because we can't get rid of the sulfur dioxide fast enough. So let's add some ore valves and vents, I guess. Well, we just put something like that and a vent. That is apparently still not enough. But it seems like most of it is running now, so that's nice at least. Some of these aren't. Well, there's still some in all of the lines, I guess. Let's add some at the top as well. Oh, we already had a half at the top. Oh well. Should we just do this same thing at the bottom and then Tom? So, is everything running again? It seems like it, to me. And we're starting to have a backup of lead oxide again, that's good. And we need more vents, of course. Maybe not that many. Okay. Why is this some of these not running? Because of the oxygen again. Okay. So it is not enough. More oxygen. Seems like it can keep up now, that's good. And we can get rid of the sulfur dioxide. And we have enough lead oxide. Then it just needs to run for a bit, and then we should have enough lead to fill up some drains and soda, of course. Making sure that some of these chests are not almost entirely full while we're waiting for the chests, but it appears like they will saturated or balanced, I guess. More research. And stuff still runs, that's good. And we should still have more than enough sulfuric acid for when we actually need it. So have a look at batteries. They are producing again, that's good. Are they producing enough though? That is a question. Let's get over there and have a look. Without dying to trains. Is it this one? Yes. So we might need to beacon this up a bit more. Let's try it. I'd just rather have the trains wait at their end destinations than at where they're getting the resources from. How did I mess that up? Here, of course. Oh, that's just how it's going to be. And we are still low on lead here. Okay. How much lead does a battery take? 2. Okay. But at least it's getting filled somewhat fast now, this train. Otherwise we'll have to start producing more lead with our hopefully still excess of lead oxide. But if I don't have to, I would like to not just upscale lead, because that means we'll start venting a lot more sulfur dioxide and we might need that later, I'm not sure. I just don't want to scale up some small part of this system by a lot and then not having a look at it anytime soon. This does seem a bit slow though. But maybe that's just because most of the lead is still getting used for the solder. As there was 3 trains waiting for it. Now they start to fill those up. Hopefully the solder will back up and then we'll have more lead for ourselves. Let's just give it a bit, I guess. Let's have a look at our science productions meanwhile. For a longer period of time. So white science, only 3.8k per minute. Has that gone down recently, or when is that? Well, it is low in the last 10 minutes as well. And in the last minute, okay. Let's have a look. We are out of rocket fuel. And we only have one train going with there, apparently. So we probably need a lot more of those trains. Let's go and fix that. Then we can have a look at the lead again afterwards, if we remember, of course. Let's just see if the train doesn't arrive soon. It does. We can copy the setting from that then. Ugly, this is such a fast unload. Cool. Now, we are probably gonna run out of rocket fuel up here very soon, but that is a fixable problem. How were the other sciences doing? So blue is also only 3.1k, 2.7, 2.5. Is that something new, or is that just because we haven't given it enough time, I wonder? Red is low, at least, but I don't think we improved the red production yet, did we? I'll have to look into that. Blue have been good in the last 10 minutes at least, so that's good. How about purple and yellow? Why can't I see those? Have we just not been producing any of those? Yellow science. Apparently... Oh, because we have... Yeah, of course, we're backed up on those. I limited the warehouses at our science labs, so we got backed up on those. That's quite alright. That's as expected. Actually, we will probably start or stop, sorry, running or launching rockets soon, sorry. At least if we limit these chests. Not sure if we should. I think we should, honestly. So, limit all of these. If I can find all of the chests without ruining everything. That means we'll stop launching rockets, I think. Unless it just destroys the science, not sure about that. Let's have a look at what happens when it can't output anything. So it keeps at least 1000 white science in its inventory. Can it launch this rocket then? Appears like it did. Will it just stockpile all the science here then? Not sure. Then we'll just have to limit the inserter that's putting the... this one, the satellite in. But it is stockpiling it, it doesn't destroy anything, so that's maybe okay. I just want to see how much it will actually stockpile. Are these not limited at all? Nope. I think that is okay, it's not that much. I mean, we are using a lot to launch rockets, so that's okay. It's only 10. Items per stack, and we do need almost, if without the productivity we needed 100 stacks so, per rocket. Did we not get any science from our... Nope. We need to limit these ones. We are just wasting resources now. Let's not do that. So, how about instead we connect this to the logistic network and say that if science is below 3 chests with 2000 per... Let's just say that if one of the slots in each of the Actually, it needs to know this the its own rocket's output, because otherwise the outer ones will just be full at all times and it'll still launch more rockets. So let's tie it into just these chests, I guess. That does mean that we need wire, and I'm not carrying any of that around, so we'll probably have to go back to base. Let's do that. But let's just do it now, and still try to remember that we had to look at lead again. Wire. Give me some wire, please, if you have anything. Or maybe some insulated wire. Is there anything? There was some insulated wire. One. And there was some... Okay, that's good enough, I guess. We just needed a bit so we can take a blueprint of it. Actually, let's get rid of the red one, I guess. Good. As long as we have a bit more than three wires, we can just copy paste it for free. Whoops, I went too far. There's some new resources for you. Good, so. Whoops, that was already made. So now this should know without the logistics network. Circuit network. If the white science is below 6K. So if the chests are less than half full, it is allowed to work. And it should take from there and put down there. And it won't right now because we have a lot of science. Let's just pull that out of there. And then we just copy these, I guess, the full setup. Oh yeah, of course, it's putting down the inserters again. Good. We will start producing again as soon as we have what we... Oh, we can get rid of the white science. Maybe I should do what I said earlier and actually expand the science, because we're not using stuff very fast right now. Can we see a consumption of our items? Science somehow over here. Let's take for 10 minutes. There. Only 1.4K, that's not a lot. We need more, definitely. Well, we can't do that here, we don't have the yellow belt. Before we forget, let's go and have a look. Oh, we can just do that here, you know. Let's go and have a look at the lead again. See if we actually produce what we need and that the battery production has started up a bit faster again, or keep going at least. Where is the lid? Up there. Well, at least there's no trains waiting right now. We do not have that big of a stockpile of it, but that's okay, I think. Let's have a look at the trains. The train is still unloading, that's good. And we have 45k here now. These are full, right? Yeah, they are. This won't get full though, but that's okay. Seems like they actually need larger requester chests, cause that one ran out just for a short while. These ones far away should probably wanna run out of more often. They are only requesting 28, so that is 14 crafts. Not sure why it ran out the other one. Maybe because of robots. Because apparently they are not fast enough. And we haven't gotten more robots since we tried to get that up and running again. Is that just because I didn't finish it? Where did I put robot production? I thought I put it... Yeah, it is here, sorry. I just saw these and thought that's not it. So we are producing Mark 1 robot frames again. That means we are producing Mark 1 robots as well, right? Unless we removed that one. I think we did. Can we somehow manage that from here? Nope, can't set a recipe. I needed to reduce Mark 1 logistic robots, sorry. Yellow logistic robots. We don't have any of those, right? Only red. Yeah, I removed it, so that's why we're not producing any logistic robots still. Let's have a look at the lead. Still not producing full time, okay. That's a bit sad, but maybe we will have to increase this lead production soon. But first, let's go back to base, produce more labs, and get the robots running, or building, or assembling. Robots. That should be better. Let's just put a lab producer down here. I'm not sure how many can be in a stack of those, but we'll see. Let's keep improving the robot production, I guess. Flying robot frames, Mark 2. And let's not tear the old setup down before we're ready with this one this time. Oh. These power poles are ridiculous. And please fix your power pole lines. Oh, come on. That's better. Get rid of these weird old ones. But unfortunately, that's all we got time for in this episode. So thank you all for joining me, and I'll see you next time. Bye.